What's good? It is your boy Bake. Welcome back to my channel. Today we're talking about gameplay on the court, gameplay, and the top three things I definitely want to see impactful for this year's NBA 2K22 gameplay. But before we do that, I need y'all to spam up the lockdown gang. I'm at work, so I can't get crazy. Anyway, let's talk about some on-court gameplay changes that we see in the courtside report from July. The first one, the very first one they dropped, they said key on-court gameplay improvements are being implemented to give the player not only more control over how they score the ball, but also how they counter those moves on the defensive end. That's only the beginning. Most impactful gameplay changes will be introduced along with the first NBA 2K22 gameplay reveal trailer coming out later in August. So we know tomorrow is the last day, so we know it's dropping tomorrow. We don't know what time, but be on the lookout for it to drop tomorrow. This is what it said about some of the things they're going to be working on. Breaking down defenders off the ball for dribbling, new signature moves, new combos, precision, jumps, shooting, dunking in traffic, and pulling off alley hoops have all become more skill-based. I still don't know what that means, but that's what they said. It's going to be more skill-based now. Basketball IQ and stick skills play an even bigger role in separating top offensive players. I mean, we've seen 2K talk about things like this before, but will they execute? That's the biggest thing. Will they finally execute on these things that they're talking about, especially for the gameplay? Because we know the two biggest things that they need is gameplay and a great builder. Having those two things with great rewards will make an amazing game. And games will always have problems, but having a builder, having gameplay, and rewards make a game go really, really well. They also talked about some of the defensive things, right? It said a completely revamped shot contest and blocking system, highlight an arsenal of new defensive tools at your disposal. Playing suffocating defense on the perimeter and in the paint has never felt more rewarding, giving elite defenders the ability to truly change the outcome of the game. Now, lockdown gang, I truly hope this is real. I really do, because I think we need balance on both sides of the basketball. I still do believe that we need our own animations for defense, but maybe they put it in and we don't know. Pause, that just sounded bad. Maybe they added some of those features and we just don't know about it yet, and we'll know about it tomorrow, but I hope that they added something like that, or they're working towards adding defensive animations, because we know if you don't add it to your player, then you're at the mercy of the game, you're at the mercy of the RNG, you're at the mercy of whatever the game wants to happen at what given time. Mike Wayne said there's less dice roll. He said that there's going to be some major changes to stick skills, but will it be? I can definitely see some improvements to the offense, especially with some of the badges that we saw, like quick chain. I already know what that probably means. That means you're going to be able to quick chain or chain dribbles move together. And I'm already knowing dribble guys are going to be super OP, because every time they add a new badge, it breaks the game. I don't know why. It just breaks the game. Quick first step broke the game. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of these badges break the game. You know, spot of precision, break the game. Blinders, break the game. Like, these badges breaks the game. And it's always offensively overpowering. Defensive badges don't work. We got Hall of Fame ankle braces, and we get broken off all the damn time. Every single second, every single minute, we get dunked on. Don't matter if we got interior or not. It's just rough in these streets for the defensive end. And I think it's time for us to see some love on the defensive end. I know my man All City talked about the SARS doing the defensive now and how he's going to be making some of the changes this year. And I truly do hope that he actually made some good changes this year for the defensive end. And I hope we have an ability to play great defense out here, because I want to be able to play great defense. I do. I want to be able to compete. I want to be able to lock people up. I want to be able to do a lot of great things on the defensive end. I know a lot of people want to be dribblers. A lot of people want to be shooters. But I want to be able to defend. I want to be a defender. I want to sit in the stands. I want to play defense. I want to stop my player from scoring the basketball on a regular basis. Of course, you're going to get scored on. It's 2K. Everything, everybody's going to get scored on. But I want it to be less on randomness and more on skill. Like, if I play against somebody that's better than me, I'm okay with them being better than me. But if I play against somebody that's not better than me, and I know they're not better than me, and they're getting anything they want because the game is not allowing me to move the way I want to move, I'm going to be upset. I definitely would like to see some big changes when it comes to the movement, when it comes to the way our players react. And I did, just most importantly, I want to see some defensive badges, some new defensive badges that helps improve our defense. And I really think that's going to determine based off the builder and the my player builder at the end of the day. But the gameplay trailer is dropping tomorrow. I hope y'all excited. What are y'all looking forward to when it comes to the gameplay trailer? I am ready to find out what are the changes that's coming. We're right around the corner. We're less than, 8, 9, 10 days away before 2K comes out. So let's get it, man. Let me know in the comments below. Live life, trust, let's rock. One of the best without God. My life will be a mess. Always remember to have faith, hope, and love. Can't wait for the trailer to drop tomorrow. Tuesday's about to be epic.